Okay, so whatever, let we start. Okay. So today we are going to discuss about binary codes. Now, what is that? Codes, as we know, that it is something which is related to some encryption, something like that, which we do not want to disclose among the general people, something that is encryption, or there is some security reason for which we want to make our data secret, right? So that is why coding is required. Now, there are various coding available nowadays. Various types of codings are available. So this you will learn in your, there is a subject called information theory and coding. There is also one particular subject. You can learn that one further. Right now, we'll be learning about a very basic coding, which are generally being used in digital system design. So these are three. There are, one is called the BCD code or binary coded decimal. Number two is gray code. And number three is XS3 code. So these are generally the very popular codes which are used in digital system design. We'll be starting with the first one, BCD code. What is that? As the name suggests, it will code the binary numbers in such a manner so that every decimal number can be expressed. So that is why it is called a BCD code. Now, as already we know about the binary numbering system, likely, maybe we are having some decimal number. Is there still any voice issue?
Yes, sir, slight a bit.
Okay. Binary and then BCD. Okay, so we know that we can have these codes like this. In case of binary, you can write it down. If we write the decimal number into 4-bit binary code or binary number system, all I am writing in binary, so it looks like this, zero denoted by four zeros, right? Similarly, one denoted by 0001, two denoted 0010, three denoted by 0011, four 0100, five 0101, 60110, 70111, 8100001, 101010, 111011, 121100, and so on, right? Now, if we go for a BCD, it's called a binary coded decimal. Up to 9, it remains same like a BCD. Like a binary code, it will remain same, likely same like four codes, four digits will be there, four binary bits will be there, likely same. 0001, 0010, 0011, then it is same like 0100, 0101 0110 0111 then 100091 0001 up to this it is all right. It is as same as simple 8421 system. It is, but whenever after 9, whenever 10 is coming, make sure that we are coding it in format like 0 will be again represented by 40. So 10, 0 first will be represented by 4 zeros, and next 1 will be represented by 0001. Likely 1 as I have mentioned already, that is 1 is represented in 2 for and 1 will be represented by 3 zeros followed by 1. The binary equivalent of is 1010, whereas the BCT code of this 10 number is something different. It comes like this 0001. Then similarly, if you look after 11, again the 1 will be represented by 30 followed by 1. And then this one will be also represented by 0001. So that means individual digits are now being represented by 4 numbers. So that is why it is called a BCD, binary coded decimal. Similarly, 12 will be represented by 0001 followed by 0010 and so on. So that is the difference between a simple binary code and BCD code. So up to all will be same. Up to 9, all will be same. But after 9, whenever 2 digits are coming in case of decimal number, corresponding binary and BCD value, BCD codes are getting different combinations. Generally, application of this particular BCD code, we generally use in case of display unit. You may probably know that we are having nowadays the digital clocks are there, where we have the displays like this, you know, an individual digit display like this, right? So there are 7 displays. We will be discussing that one further. There are 7 displays are there. These are called A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. There are 7 displays. 7 LEDs are actually glowing inside that display. And in order to drive this particular display unit, in order to drive this, we require, because it's an individual digit we can display right over here, likely 0 can be displayed, 1 can be displayed, 2 can be displayed, 3, 4, and as it is, like. So from 0 to 9, it can display. That is why the input to this particular IC is a driver. Is a driver IC, which is being run by the BCD code. So there are 7 segments for which there are 7 connections in between that particular IC driver, right? There are 7 lines or 7 connections in between that IC driver and this particular display. And that IC driver, these are the outputs of that IC driver. These are the outputs. 7 outputs are there. The input for that IC drivers are actually that BCD code. That BCD code, right? So it's called actually BCD to 7 segment display decoder or BCD to 7 segment IC driver, whatever. So we'll be discussing that one, how to design that particular driver. That is included in your syllabus. So right now, the application of that BCD, as you know, that whenever we require a single digit to be displayed or to be created by some binary values, we use BCD. If multiple digits are required to be displayed, then individually, so this one, the display one, then similarly display two, display three, and at the back end, there will be IC driver one, IC driver two, and BCD code for individual digits you need to supply. Okay, whatever. So that is something like BCD code. The difference from a simple binary code and BCD code is that for binary code, it's not limited to a single digit. The bits can be represented as 8421 system, but in case of BCD, though it is also in 8421 system, but that is for a single digit, single decimal digit. So whenever multiple digits are coming, individual digits we need to take and we need to code that one into a 4-bit binary equivalent number. Let me come to the next one. The next one is gray code. So this is a gray code. Now, what is that? Initially, let me start with the same thing that we know, that is the binary code. And then we'll be writing the gray code of that one so that we can understand it better. So let we provide the names as B0, B1, B2, B3. These are the corresponding binary codes. Binary codes, and let I write down the gray code right over here. So gray codes, generally we provide the names as G0, G1, G2, G3, something like this. Okay. So how to write down this one? Let I write down the binary codes. Same thing. So that is why you need to remember these codes always. So these are the 16 different codes for binary value for the corresponding decimal number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Just hold for a minute. Sorry. So let me start again. So this is actually the binary codes for decimal number 0 to 15. So in order to make a gray code of this one, so if you go for the gray code, initially you can start looking after the binary codes, how it look like. If you look after the LSB, you can see it's repeating 01010101 and so on, right? Next, if you look after the B1, you will see that it looks like 00110011, and continuously it's going on like this, 00110011, right? Then B2, 40, then followed by 41s, again 40 followed by 41s, and finally if you look after the B3, you will be getting that 80 continuous and then followed by 81s are there. So this is one of the thing that you can notice while writing the binary code. In case of gray code, you can see that it will start like this. So in order to write down the gray code, I am using this logic, that is, will be starting like this, 01, as it is same like B0. Then I'll produce one mirror right over. I'll place one mirror right over here. So the mirror reflection will come like this, 10. Again, I'll place some mirror. It will come like this, 01. Again, I'll place one mirror. It will come like this, so on. So this is how the LSB can be formed for gray code, LSB, that is. Coming to the next one. So this is after two individual bits, we are placing the mirror. Now we are actually placing the mirror after 4 bits. So again, the same 4 bits I'm copying, 0011. Then I am placing one mirror right over here. So it will look like 1100. Followed by another mirror, 0011, followed by another mirror, 1100. Next, we have to copy 8 bits. So 8 means 4 zeros followed by 4 ones. Then I'll place one mirror. So that would be 4 ones first, followed by 4 zeros. And after that, obviously, the MSB. So this is the MSB for binary, and this is the MSB for your gray. So for gray MSB, obviously, we need to go for 16 and then we need to place the mirror. But it's only for 16. So that is why it will be same as it is as B3. So 8 numbers of zeros followed by 8 numbers of ones. So this is actually the gray code, how it looks like. And this is the gray code for, zero. For corresponding zero, the gray code is also 0000. For one, it is 0001. For two, it is 0011, and so on, like this. The advantage or the main reason for which we are saying we are making this gray code is that it is also called a mirror code, as the mirrors are being placed in order to make this particular coding. The another advantage is that if you look after the consecutive two codes, you can see that there is only 1 bit difference is there. Now you can see that this is the first one, having 4 numbers of zero. In the second one, there are 3 numbers of zero, as it is same like the other upper one. The last bit has been changed. Now, if you go for these two corresponding codes, you can see that this is 0001, this is 0011. So only this position, 1 bit has been changed. and so on. You can see any two consecutive location, any two consecutive coding, you will be getting that only one position where the value has been changed. That is why these gray codes are mainly used in case of 1-bit error detection technique. So this is actually used for error detection technique, and we have the mirror code like this. So we'll be discussing how to generate this one, what is the circuit by which we can generate this one. So once we start our circuit designing, because right now we don't know about how to make our circuit, so that is why only the codings I'm discussing. And this is the gray code. The difference from the binary code is that first of all, binary code is an 8421 system code, or it obeys the law of 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 3. This coding or this law, but gray code do not obey that one. It's not that 8421 system, it is not obeying that one. You can see 2 is denoted by 0011, so you cannot say it's an 8421 system. No, it is not like that. So this is another property of gray code. And the most important property of this one, that the consecutive two codes have only 1-bit difference. So this is something gray code. Coming to the last one, that is excess code, excess 3 code. The excess 3 code, last one, what is that? Excess 3 code, it is also one kind of BCD code. It is also one kind of BCD code. So let we come to BCD first, because only for BCD you can get the excess 3. Only for BCD you can get the excess 3. So BCD code is something like starts with 4 zeros followed by this one. So actually BCD code is only from 0 to 9. So these are the decimal equivalent, 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. this is the only equivalent 0 to 9 of BCD code. Now for excess 3, as the name suggests, that it is actually excess by 3 bits. So that means 0 plus 3 means 3. So in case of excess 3, the value would be 0, 0, 1, 1, something like this. So if I write down this one as E0, E1, E2, E3, and it is as B0, B1, B2, B3, four consecutive bits. So for 0, BCD code is 4 zeros, but the excess 3 code is 0011. Why 0011? You can put this one as also 8421 system. You can put that one like that. So this is 0 plus 3. So that is 0011. Similarly, 1 would be 4. So that is 0100. 2 would be 5. That is 0101. 3 would be 6, that is 0110. 4 would be 7, so 0111. 5 would be 8. 6 is actually that is 1011, and then it is 1100. This is actually the BCT code. Okay. Now, why XS3? Why this code we have written? A code down a little longer. Why only XS3? Why not XS4 or XS5? Why not that one? So if you look after this, it's also called a self-complementary code. Self-complementary code. What is that? If you look up the zero. So what is the ninth complement of zero? So ninth complement of zero is 9 minus 0, right? So 9 minus 0 is 9. Fine. So these two are actually self complements or the complements. So 0's complement is 9, 9's complement is 0. So if you look up to this position is 0011, it's just complement is 9, 1100, right? If you look this two, 0011 corresponding complement is 1100. Directly it has come. If you look after this one, next one, if you look after this, that is 1, the complement of 1 is 9 minus 1, that is 8. So its complement should be this one. Now if you look after this, it is 0100, rather it is 1011, just opposite. 0 has come to 1, 1 has come to 0, 0 has come to 1, and 0 has come to 1. So just the opposite you can find out. So that is why it's called a self-complementary code, and so on. If you look after this 2 value, this one, so its complement should be 2 complement is 7, because 7 plus 2 is 9. So 2's complement is 7. So here also you can see, so for 2 it is 0101, for 7 it is 1010. So this one is the complement of this one, right? So that is why it's called a self-complementary code. And make sure that XS3 and BCD all are having the values only from 0 to 9 only. So this is for individual digits. But for binary and gray, they are having binary codes and gray codes. They are having the value. They are 4 bits slightly like this. This is a binary code for 4 bit. This is up to 1111, right? So total 16 values are there. Similarly for gray also, there are 16 different values are there. Am I clear? This one. So any query for these types of coding? So I have learned about BCD code. We have learned about gray code, learned about XS3 code, and obviously earlier we have learned the binary code. Am I clear? This one, any query for this section? Any query?
No, sir. Sir, to gray code type work to dekhaben.
The gray code. So gray code is something like this. Whenever you are writing the gray code, make sure that you should write it starting from here. So write down the binary code 0101 is coming like this 0101. So repetition is after 2 bit, right? 01, then again that 01 is repeating, right? So in case of gray code, we are placing 01, then we are providing one mirror so that the reflection of 01 is coming back like this, 10, then again 01, then again 10, and so on. Okay, so after that, next is for B1, it is 0011. Similarly here, 0011. But after 0011, that means 4 bit, we are placing the mirror. So first 2 bit, we place mirror, consecutive 2 bit, we are placing the mirrors. Then after 4 bits, we are, voice is not clear. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think that there is no further query for this. Okay. Let me come to the next one. Next topic, actually. So right now, so far, what we have learned about the binary number system. Rather, we have discussed about few things about how to change from one number system to another number system. Then we have learned about the binary arithmetic, and where we have found that how to add simple binary numbers, then subtract, multiplication, division, followed by some complementary method, likely in case of decimal, that was 9's complement method, 10's complement subtraction method. In case of binary number system, there were the 1's complement method of subtraction, 2's complement method of subtraction. And today we have started with the coding. Likely there are mainly three codings we have learned, that is gray code, BCD code, XS3 code. And so we'll be right now, we'll be moving towards a new part, which you know a little bit. That is the, in the first day, someone among you has told me that digital means something gate. So we'll be starting with the gates right now. Okay. So let me start about how to realize this thing, because so far what we have discussed, that is simple with respect to number systems. That is not at all a physical thing we have learned. So now, right now we'll be starting with some physical design, or how the engineering design can be performed with binary number system or with digital system, how a system can be designed. So for that, obviously, as you know, it's a digital electronics, you can say, or digital system design is also a part of a digital electronics. Electronics is actually a part of electrical engineering, as you know. So obviously, we should know how to make something with the help of flow of current, or by producing some voltage, how to work, right? So that is something like which, that is the way of electrical engineering. We want to make our every machines or every gadgets and to work over there. So in case of digital electronics also, the basic thing is that we need to know how these numbers can be represented in form of electrical signals, and then those electrical signals, how can we manage to design something, design a system, so that that system can solve some problems. So that was the beginning of the digital electronics or digital electronics subject. Now, in order to do that one, obviously, for any electrical system we need to design, we require some sort of devices, right? We need to design, first of all, we require some sort of devices. Now, obviously, you probably know that devices, or in sense, you can say components, electrical components. So there are various electrical components are there, right? So these components, generally, we know that there are two types of components for electrical system. One is called the passive components. Passive components. Another is called the active components. Now, who will tell me which is passive component and which is active component? Who will tell me that one? Which is passive component and which is active component? Passive component kake bole, active component kake bole? You are learning solid state electronics. solid-state devices.
Sir, passive or resistor capacitor?
Resistance capacitor.
Inductor, diode, inductor. Transformer.
Diode transformer, all are passive.
Okay. Yes.
So which one is active?
Sir, battery, generator.
Battery, generators, these are active components. Okay. From where you have got this particular answer? Any book?
No, sir. I think it is active element and passive element.
Which one is active element and which one is passive element?
Sir, resistor, capacitor, inductor are passive elements and battery generator, they are active elements.
Okay. And what about diode, transistor, these things? Are they passive or are they active?
They are passive elements.
They are all passive elements. No. Few examples you have given correct, but you... the components or elements what you have mentioned about diode, transistor and those things, those are also active elements or active components also you can say. So the point is passive components or passive elements are resistor, capacitor, inductor, right? These are the passive components or passive elements, but for active component, all generators, batteries, then the electronic components like diode, transistors, these are also passive noy ekloche, these are also active components. Why active? Because it has got that power to store the energy and to change the energies in such a manner that one of the component, either current or voltage, can be incremented. So that is why these are also active. In case of transistor, you can increase the current value. In case of diode, you can restrict the current value. So there is a control technology is there. This RCL can't do that one. It cannot generate itself. But in case of transistor, at least one of the electrical parameter that can be generated or that can be amplified at least, or that can be increased at least. So that is why all these components or elements are also in the group of active component. Make sure about this one, that only three components are there which are passive, that is resistor, capacitor and inductor. Rest, diode, transistors, SCR, all these things which are belonging to the semiconductor families, mostly those semiconductor family based devices are active devices or active components. And devices is something different. Whenever you are using for a particular purpose, then those are actually devices. So make sure about that. The diode, transistors are also devices. And we know that all the electrical circuits are actually built with these passive components and active components, maybe only with the help of passive components, or maybe with a mixture of passive and active components. Only active component based circuits generally we do not found. At least resistance or a conductor path should be there. So that is why we say generally all the circuits, electrical circuits, are built with active and passive components. Okay, I don't know from where you have found that diode and transistors are passive. Have you found anywhere diode and transistors are passive?
Actually,
transformer active, but diode, transistors, these are also active. So as I have mentioned, only three আর দেয়ার রেজিস্ট্যান্স, ক্যাপাসিটার অ্যান্ড ইন্ডাক্টর, দিজ আর অ্যাকচুয়ালি প্যাসিভ। এইগুলো হচ্ছে বেসিক্যালি প্যাসিভ, রেস্ট মোস্ট অফ দেম আর অ্যাক্টিভ। সো দ্য পয়েন্ট ইজ নাও, অবভিয়াসলি ফর মেকিং এনি ডিজিটাল সার্কিট উইল বি অলসো রিকোয়ারিং দিস দিস সর্ট অফ কম্পোনেন্টস। এই কম্পোনেন্ট দিয়েই ডিজিটাল সার্কিটগুলো তৈরি হবে। বাট অ্যাজ ডিজিটাল সার্কিট আর অ্যাকচুয়ালি বিলঙ্গিং টু সাম সেপারেট সেকশন অফ ইউনো স্টাডি, পড়াশোনার একটা একদমই সেপারেট এরিয়া, সেপারেট জায়গা, হোয়ার উই জেনারেলি ডিল উইথ জিরোজ অ্যান্ড ওয়ানস কাইন্ড অফ থিংস, উই হ্যাভ বিল্ড সাম বেসিক সার্কিট মডিউলস ইউজিং দিস প্যাসিভ অ্যান্ড অ্যাক্টিভ কম্পোনেন্টস, অ্যান্ড উই স্টাডি the entire subject or we design everything with the help of that basic circuits. Tar mane ki it's like that whenever we are making design and digital design, obviously we need to deal with these values, this sort of 10 kind of thing. Now 10 directly we generally do not say that is it is something related to some current or voltage or frequency. We directly do not deal with that one, rather simple on off kind of thing we generally say, logic on, logic off, logic, something like this. Now obviously in order to make our circuit which will work with this logics only, we require a special kind of circuit, right? That circuit should be built with this thing, because we know that every circuit are built with passive and active components. Tale passive or active component dei amar circuit gulo toiri hoy. But in sense, whenever we are dealing with digital electronics, we require a basic few building blocks which indeed deal with only zeros and ones. And those basic circuits which deals with the 0-1 logics are called logic gates. So the basic circuits, basic circuits used to design a digital logic circuit, digital logic circuit, the basic circuit used to design a digital logic circuit is called logic gates. Make sure about this one. That means the basic circuits are actually the logic gates. So whenever we'll be learning about the digital circuits, make sure that directly we are not going to design the circuit in terms of RLC, diode, transistor, generator, battery, those kind of things. Those sort of things we will not deal with that one, but make sure that we'll be dealing with logic gates. Now the logic gates, there are different logic gates are there as you have learned already. Now these logic gates, obviously these logic gates are actually built with this electrical components, passive components, active components. Eigulo diye kintu ei logic gate gulo toiri hoyeche. That means if you are looking for a NAND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, this sort of gates, these are built with the resistance, the capacitor, the inductor is not generally being present, along with some transistors transistors and so on, right? So it requires this sort of components also. As these are electrical circuits, make sure it requires some sort of battery power supply or biasing, right? As we know, all the electronic devices like your diode, transistors, it requires some sort of biasing. Biasing chhara kintu, without biasing, it will not work. Because as we know, in order to flow the free carriers, we require some external energy. Otherwise, semiconductors acts like insulators. Even if you have made a lot of doping over there, tumi prochur doping korecho, very huge amount of free carriers you have generated inside those devices, inside those semiconductors, still you require some external energy in form of mainly biasing. So that is, biasing means obviously you require some battery source, right? So the gates also will require. So it is built with RL and RC and transistors generally. They are also there. Diodes are also there. Whatever, mainly built with this one. And it should be driven by battery. And as you know, that biasing, obviously, we prefer biasing should be DC biasing. AC biasing, we generally do not prefer. We generally provide DC biasing because AC biasing always, the flow of movement of carriers will be continuously haphazard if you provide AC biasing to any electronic devices like diode and transistor. Obviously, for diode, opposite direction current will not flow at all. So similarly for transistor also. So continuously, desired. So for continuous flow of current, the biasing should be DC biasing, and that is why we require battery source or anything which is DC in nature, DC source. So these are the basic requirement. We require a circuit to be designed by RC and transistors, the logic gates, and logic gates also will require battery source or biasing voltage in order to drive. But as these things are very common to all logic gates, that means all logic gates are built with transistors. Maybe resistances are there, but at least transistors are there. Whatever. So all logic gates are built with transistors. All are driven by battery voltage source. So we do not mention that one whenever we are designing a digital circuit or a digital system. We are not mentioning that one. That is the reason we go for simple symbols of logic gates only. We go for the symbols of logic gates, and we work with simple that gates only. So we neglect this part that, okay, they are within that, there are some transistors. Within that, we require some biasing battery voltage. So we neglect that part, and we mainly focus over the logical operation. And that is why the digital circuits, whenever we'll be designing one digital circuit, we'll be dealing with the gates, starting with the basic gates, what you have learned in your higher secondary. There are two types of gates, logic gates. One is basic gate. Rather, three types. Two is universal gate. And number three is exclusive gate. So these are generally the three types of gates. We have learned all about this. Now, let me just provide a little bit, with that. So starting with the first one, basic gates, there are three basic gates are there. Three basic gates, starting with the very basic one, NOT gate, right? Obviously, gates are such kind of circuit which works with logic, digital logic. So everything we will be dealing with one and zero logic, or rather on and off logic. So instead of on and off, generally we write down one and zero. Why? Because on and off, jodi bar bar likhte hai, so it will take some time. Instead of that, we write down zero and one, but that doesn't mean zero means 0 volt, one means 1 volt. No, never. It can be, but it is not always. 0 can be 0 volt, 0 can be some minus voltage, or 0 can be something positive voltage also. Okay. It's the point is 0 means logic 0. 1 means logic 1. 1 can be that logic 1 can be represented by 5 volt, can be represented by 2.5 volt, can be represented by 3.3 volt. Everything can be possible. Even nowadays in your modern computers, it can be represented with the help of 1.8 volt also. Okay. So whatever, we'll be discussing that one further. Right now, make sure that this 0 and 1 are only logic. Logic means either on or off. It's a switching circuit kind of thing, right? So for NOT gate, the logic, as you know, the logic is that it will generate the output as the inverted logic of the input. So output, so definition is output is the inverted logic of the input. Make sure you should know this one. Okay, so what is that? We provide generally some sort of symbols, and the symbol looks like this. As you know, it looks like this. We provide here a inverted or the complementary output. Inverted means obviously that is also complementary output. So here we found A bar. So if we provide here A signal, a particular signal is there, which is a logical signal, maybe 0, maybe 1. If it is 0, we'll be finding out 1 here. If it is 1, we will be finding out 0 here. So that you know. And this is actually a symbol. Make sure that it is only a symbol. It's not that particular circuit. It's the symbolic view. The circuit is within this one, which is made of that transistor. So we generally say, it's a symbolic view. Okay. And that's, you know, the diagram what we draw with the help of logical gates, with the help of logic gates, we generally say the logical diagram. Maybe in case of digital electronics, your question paper, you may find out that draw the circuit diagram is also being written right over there in few cases. But it's actually the logical diagram. Okay, it's not the circuit diagram, because circuit diagram generally something different. It's called the symbolic logical diagram with the help of these gates. Make sure about this one. So you have learned this, and when we are making one gate, obviously the gate will be having some input. So this is the input side and this is the output side, right? So from this side, the output is being generated. So the relationship between input and output can be written in a table format. That table format is actually known as truth table. So make sure a table which provides the input and output relationship for all possible combinations of inputs is called a truth table. So what is right for here? So if we provide the input name as A, the input terminal name or the node name as A, the output node name, maybe I'm providing the name as Y. Generally, we provide the output name as Y. Okay. In books also you can find some other names also, but generally I prefer to provide their Y. You can provide your own name, whatever. So make sure that whatever the name you are providing right over here and right at the input side should be reflected as it is in your truth table, like this. So this is my input, this is my output. So it'll be generally we write down input in the left hand side and output in the right hand side. And in the input section, we'll be writing the node A and output is Y, right? So this is how the truth table are being written. জেনারেলি ট্রুথ টেবিল এইভাবে লেখা হয়। সো ইট ইজ ইফ দ্য ইনপুট, সো হোয়াট আর দ্য পসিবল কম্বিনেশনস অফ ইনপুট, ইনপুট এ ক্যান বি আইদার জিরো অর ওয়ান, সো ফর জিরো অর ওয়ান, সো দিস ক্যান বি ইনপুট। ইফ ইট ইজ জিরো, অবভিয়াসলি উই নো আউটপুট শুড বি ইনভার্টেড ভার্সন অফ দ্যাট ওয়ান, সো জিরো উইল প্রডিউস আউটপুট ওয়ান অ্যান্ড ওয়ান উইল প্রডিউস আউটপুট জিরো। সো দিস ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি দ্য ট্রুথ টেবিল অফ দ্য নট গেট, দিস ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি দ্য ট্রুথ টেবিল অফ দ্য নট গেট হুইচ আই হ্যাভ ড্রন রাইট ওভার হেয়ার। সো ইনস্টেড অফ এ ইফ ইউ রাইট ডাউন এক্স অ্যান্ড ইফ ইউ রাইট ডাউন ওয়াই, সো দে আর ইউ হ্যাভ টু মেনশন এক্স অ্যান্ড ওয়াই অ্যাজ ইট ইজ, it's not that mandatory you have to write down a, and the expression for y function is equal to a complement, the y function is equal to a complement, make sure about that one. Complement means inverted version. Okay, so inverted version generally denoted by a complement can be written as a bar like this, or also you can write it like this. A complement can also be written like this. So this is the complement symbol. Okay. So make sure that whenever we are having some complementary output, we provide this symbol, this bubble symbol. This bubble denotes complementary output. This triangle denotes it's a buffer. So buffer followed by one bubble. So make sure that if you have any design where you are getting only this one, so no bubble is there. Any symbol contains only this one, no bubble is there. Make sure whatever be the input, that is the output you will be getting. So it's not an inverted output. If you provide here a bubble, it gets inverted. So bubble denotes inverted output. Make sure about this one. Bubble always denotes the inverted output. But if it is not bubble, so it's called a buffer. Buffer means whatever be the input, that would be the output. Okay. Buffer can be an analog buffer, can be a digital buffer also. Okay. Analog buffer generally used or generally built with op-amps. Op-amp you have learned already. Op amp porecho, have you learned op amp? Hopefully, have you learned op amp, operational amplifier? Or only? Okay. So we'll be learning that one maybe in further semester, whatever. So buffer can be built with operational amplifiers, whatever be the input, that is the output. And whatever be the input, if we require the opposite at the output, we provide inverter. Okay, so inverter symbol comes with bubble. Make sure about this one. So that is not gate, very simple thing. Now coming to the next one, which is your another basic gate, which is maybe OR gate. I can write it down as OR gate first. You have learned this one already. OR gate have got multiple inputs. Make sure that NOT gate has got only one input. So this is having one input only. One input. Okay. So never you'll be finding out one NOT gate having multiple inputs. Make sure about this one. So NOT gate always have only one input. The logic is whatever the single input, output is inverted. Well, OR gate, it has got multiple inputs. Maybe two input, maybe three input, maybe n numbers of inputs can also be there. So we'll be discussing about the multiple inputs. So it has got now multiple inputs. So multiple inputs. And output, the logic, there should be some logic. That is why it's called a gate. The logic is that output is high if one of the input is high, then the output is high. Okay, so that is something like the logic of OR gate. So if any one, more than one also be high at the input, but if at least one of the input is high, then the output goes high. So the logic is output goes high. Output goes high if either of the input is high. Or you can say also at least one of the input is high. Now, obviously, the truth table for OR gate can be, I am writing down for two inputs. So truth table for two input OR gate. Truth table for two input OR gate. Let me provide here two input name as A, B. Two naam dilam ami A, B. You can provide any other name. Okay. And the output also I am given the name as Y. So these are the input. These are the inputs and this is the output. Okay. So earlier case, we have found that only one input was there. So if one input is there, number of possible combination of input can be two, because the state are only two, either zero or one, right? So one input can be two, but for two input, there would be how many numbers of combination can be there? Obviously, two to the power two combinations, because either 0 or 1, so that is 2, and then this 2, so 2 to the power 2 combination, that means 4 possible combinations can be written. So what are those 4 possible combinations? Either 0 0 or 0 1 or 1 0 or 1 1. These are the 4 combinations that can be possible. You can see that there is no further combinations you can write down. Right? No further combinations you can write down with the help of two inputs. Duto input a binary, you cannot write down any further combination. Only these four combinations are possible. Now, why I have written starting with 00, 01, 10, 11? Because of that, 00 will be denoted by 0. This will denote 1, this will denote 2, and this will denote 3. As it is like a 8-4-2-1 system. So if you consider this one as 2, this one as 1. So 0 means both 0, 1 means this one should be 1, 2 means this one 1, this one 0, and 3 means this 2 are 1, 1. So that is why I have written this combination starting with 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1. And many book or almost all book follow the same combination patterns, right? So you can also start with 0, 1, then 1, 0, then 0, 0, then 0, 1. You can write down in that manner also. But the point is, generally, we write down by maintaining this sequence, starting with 0, 0, then 0, 1, then 1, 0, then 1, 1. Make sure about this one. And as the logic says that output would be high if at least any one input is high. Jekono ekta input high hole, output would be high. So for this case, obviously both the inputs are zero, so output would be low. For this case, this one is high, so output would be high. For this case also, this one is high, so output would be high. And for last combination, here both the inputs are high, so also output would be high. Make sure that do not mess up with one and one, or one is two. No, it's not like that. So it is high or it is high, so that means output is also high. Okay, generally we write down the OR gate in the Boolean function or the expression we generally write down for OR operation. You know this one. We generally write down like this: Y is equal to A or B. So this is the logical OR operation symbol, A or B, or also we can say A union B. Instead theory is called the union. So also you can write down A union B. Maybe you can write down this one also. But generally, in case of digital electronics or digital system design, we generally do not prefer to write down in this way. Erokom amra likhi na. Rather, we write down this one simply like this, A plus B. Okay. And as you also know that the symbol looks like this. The symbol looks like this. Eram ekta dekhte symbol hai. So obviously, A, B, and this is Y. You can write down here also, Y is equal to A plus B or A or B. Okay. Now you know probably this one, right? Make sure that do not ask me why the symbol is looking like this. Why not something different? Okay, so there is no reason I have found why the symbol looks like this. Irakumi cannot dekhte hoy. As like I haven't found yet why A looks like this. Irakumi cannot A dekhte hoy. Right? Eta eta A er bodole to erokomo dekhte hote parto. Why like this? I don't know. Hopefully, if you know that one, you can answer me, whatever. But make sure that OR gate looks like this. Erokomi dekhte hoy, the symbol. And maybe who has all mane, who invented OR gate has provided the symbol like this. Erokomi symbol tini ekechilen. Tar ichche hoychilo tini ekechilen. So any query up to this? So we can, you know about these things, right? Eglo to jana ache, right? Any query? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So I'll generally prefer that you will interact with me. If there is no query, please say, no, sir, no query. If you have any query, you may ask. Otherwise, I'll feel that, okay, everybody is sleeping and I am actually, you know, continuing the class. So in that case, just I can share a few lecture videos and you will be going through that one in your wastage of time. Time wastage, no problem. But actually, what I feel that you should interact during the class so that I feel that yes, my students are with me. Whatever. So let me come to the next one. AND gate. AND gate, the third one, the next basic gate. Obviously, it is also having multiple inputs. Multiple input. So again, here this is for two input OR gate. You can also make it for three input also. Three input or hote pare. So I'll be instead of AND gate, let we just go for the three input OR gate. So if you have three input OR gate like this, you can have three three particular inputs. Output is still Y. I'm writing down. Okay. So for three input, make sure that there would be eight numbers of combinations. Why eight numbers? 2 to the power 3. So 2 for 0 and 1 and 3 inputs. So 2 to the power 3 combinations. That means 8 combinations should be there. Likely like this. 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 and 1 1 1. Like this. Okay, so here also the same logic will appear. So this is actually three input OR gate. Three input OR gate. Truth table. So this is 0 and rest all would be 1. Because at least one of the input is 1. So that is why all are rest of the all inputs will provide or will produce output as 1. Make sure that you should remember these combinations continuously. 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 and 1 1 1, because every time we'll be requiring that one. These four combinations, the 8 combinations will require that one in every step. Let me come to, and the output Y will be that time written as A plus B plus C. Right, so A plus B plus C would be that time the logical expression you can write down for OR. Okay, so similarly you can make it for n number of inputs also. I'm not going for that one. So let we come to the AND gate. Let we come to AND gate. It's also multiple input. Multiple input. Okay, so output is high. You know, output is high when all the inputs are high. So that is the logic, right? As you know. So truth table for two input AB, output is Y. Combination 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So as the logic says, output would be high when all the inputs are high. So that means for this case, when all the inputs are high, then only output will high. Otherwise, the outputs will remain low. The symbol looks like this, AB, output Y is equal to A dot B. So that is the dot product or AND logical AND operator. Also, we can write down as A intersection B, though we generally do not write down that one. Intersection, we generally do not write down in case of digital electronics. Okay. So whatever, so this is the AND operator. Coming to the next one, so these are the basic three gates, NOT gate, OR gate, AND gate. It can be also written for multiple inputs, like three input, four inputs, likely like this. Coming to the next one, that is called the universal gate. Let me come quickly to next phase, universal gates. Universal gate, right? So what is that? As you know that there are two gates which can be used to implement any other types of gates. Those are called universal gates. So there are two universal gates are there. Number one, NAND gate. So we'll be starting with NAND gate. Number one is NAND gate. So as it knows, you know that NAND means AND plus NOT. Okay, so AND operation and the final AND output should be inverted. So AND plus NOT means AND operation first followed by NOT operation, like this. Now just we remove this part and we make this symbol looking like this. Dekhte kore di amra ei rokom. So it is A, it is B, it is Y. So by combining these two, what we generally draw AB, the first part of AND followed by a bubble. As I have already discussed, this bubble denotes the output would be inverted. So AND output gets inverted. Okay. So there is something NAND gate. So the logic would be simply the truth table. I am writing down the truth table. AB output Y. Again, the same thing, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Right. So four logics combinations are there. Just the opposite of AND gate, likely. So this wouldn't be zero. Rest of the three inputs will produce output as one, right? So we can say the output is low when all the inputs are high. So this is the definition of NAND gates. The output is low when all the inputs are high. So that is something like the logic of NAND gate. Similarly, NOR gate is another universal gate, as you know. The NOR gate, it's also multiple input, starts with OR, followed by NOT. So here it is, OR, followed by NOT. So the combination of the design, AB output Y. So you can draw it like this, the NOR, A, B, output Y, right? So for here, this one, AND plus NOT. So the Y can be written as a dot b, so that is the AND, followed by NOT, so overall complement, right? So that is the expression for NAND gate. Similarly, for NOR gate, it's OR followed by NOT. So A plus B is the OR followed by NOT, right? So all over, there will be a complement. So similarly, the truth table can be written as AB, output Y, 00, 01, 10, 11, right? So these are the four possible combinations. As we know, these three will be zero and only this one should be high. So output is high when all the inputs are low, right? Right. So this is output is low. Sorry, output is high when all the inputs are low. Or else also you can say output is low when at least one of the input is high. You can also say like this. So rather we'll say output is high when all the inputs are low. Right, so this is for NOR. So these two are universal gates. Why universal? Because NOR gate and NAND gates can be used to implement any other types of gates. Unno je kono gate ki implement korar jonno amra NAND gate or NOR gate use korte pari. So we'll be discussing that one further in our next class. So right now I'll be coming to the next one, next two gates, that is exclusive gates. Exclusive gates. So in case of exclusive gates, there are two types of gates. One is XOR gate, or generally also written like this, XOR gate. Happy. So XOR gate. So what is that? In case of XOR gate, the output is high when the inputs are of different types, or we can say odd numbers of inputs are high. So this is the logic. So output is high when inputs or odd numbers of inputs are high. So the truth table goes here. AB, Y, 00, 01, 10, 11, right? So output will be high. So this is zero, this is one. Here odd number of input is high, so that is why output is high. For 11, it is also again zero, right? Generally, we denote it Y is equal to A XOR. This is the exclusive OR B, exclusive OR symbol. And also can be written like this. It is A bar dot B plus A dot B bar. So why I am writing this, we'll be discussing that one when we'll be learning truth table based logical expressions, how to find out that one. Jokhon amra seta porbo tokhon ami ota bolbo. Right now keep it in mind that y is equal to a bar dot b plus a b bar. Okay, make sure about this one. This is the exclusive OR gate function. This is a symbol. Why exclusive OR? Because in case of simple OR, all these three remains one. Shokotai one hoy. But it is exclusive, something different, when one of the input is high then only it is high. If both the inputs are high, then it is not high. So that is something exclusive case is there, right? So that is why it's called an exclusive OR. Okay. And obviously, exclusive OR followed by NOT is called exclusive NOR. So we'll be starting with this one again. So exclusive OR, the symbol looks like this. Erokom dekhte ekta symbol hoy. A, B, output Y. Okay. So this is something exclusive. Why exclusive? As I have mentioned that as you know, for simple OR, all these three will remain one. So anyone, all inputs are high, any one input is high, two inputs are high, for all cases, output remains high. But in case of exclusive OR, if any one input is high, then only output is high. If all the inputs are high, then output is not high at all. Okay. Jokhon duto input high hoye gelo, tokhon output ta kintu high noy. It's low again. That is why it's exclusive. And another is there, which is exclusive NOR. So X NOR, or simply you can write down this one as X NOR, X NOR gate. As it is exclusive OR followed by NOT, right? So exclusive OR followed by NOT is exclusive NOR gate or X NOR gate. This is the opposite one, AB, output Y. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Four combinations are there. And obviously the opposite outputs are there. So output is low when odd numbers of inputs are high. So output is low. Low when odd numbers of inputs are high. Okay. Generally, it's drawn like this, first exclusive OR, and obviously followed by NOT, so there will be a bubble, right? A, B, output Y. And generally, it's denoted by Y is equal to, the symbol looks like this, a dot followed by a round, A, B, and also it is written like this, A dot B plus A bar dot B bar. Now why this expression I'm writing down, you cannot understand right now because you don't know how to find out from this boolean how to find out this one, you don't know. So that is why we'll be discussing that one further in our next class. Okay. Any query up to this basic gates, universal gates, and exclusive gates. Any query for this section? Any query for this? Is that all right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So we'll be stopping right today. We'll be discussing that one in our next class. How this.